Let's do this.
Yo, this is Nappy Boy Radio.
The Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. Live with your boy, T-Pain.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. I am your homeboy T-Pain, a.k.a. your girlfriend's boyfriend.
And I am Vanessa Fraction, hashtag Action Fraction, a.k.a. the main attraction, your partner's distraction.
And I am Pip, a.k.a. Mr. Fresh Prince, Mr. God damn!
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a great show for you tonight. Guess why I keep saying that shit? Because we do.
All the time.
I know what the fuck I'm talking about, and I'm really good at this shit. God damn it. We're actually somehow getting better.
Yes.
I didn't think we could.
No, you did.
It's all because of you.
You did it.
It's all because of you.
You did a lot of it, man.
Can't be me. Can't be me. I'm terrible at this shit.
Oh, what is your name, friend?
I'm trying to speak it into fruition, god damn it. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the one and only. That's a B-boy. Let's go. Yeah! Rock, go rock, sit back, relax, won't smile. Me, the rap assassinator. Rhymes rugged and built like Schwarzenegger. And I'ma get mad deep like a threat. Blow up your project, then take all your assets. Cause I came to shake the frame of
hell. Yes, yes, yes. Thank you.
Yes! The real Meek. What's happening, brother? How you doing?
Hey, man. You know, I'm alive. I'm breathing.
That's always good.
You know what I mean?
That's a part of it.
That's a part of
right
the
now.
Part
that's
of
a part of it.
Especially
life.
Right now. That's yeah. a part of it. Hell yeah, yeah man. Yeah. The most important question we ask on the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast, mm-hmm. How is your mental health?
You know, God is good.
That's usually what black people say.
God is good. All the time.
Come on now. I believe it.
Show us how you raised.
Absolutely. Man, I was super excited about you coming up here.
Oh, man.
Because when they said you was in town and we could have you on the show, mm-hmm. I was like, okay, cool, because I've been wanting to figure out where I know this nigga from. And me and my wife is on your Wikipedia, and we looking at your fucking IMDb, and I'm not seeing what I'm supposed to be saying. Like, not that. And then today, just sitting, I was over there fucking mixing a record. I was like, this nigga was on The Incredibles. Holy shit. That's where the fuck I know this nigga from. Just all of a sudden in my mind, I'm like, whoa, wait a minute, I know where this nigga's from.
Nice.
This nigga was one of the Incredibles.
Oh my gosh. More people saw that than I thought.
Yo, my fucking mind.
Which one?
Bro, my fucking brain exploded. The fucking, was it Cartoon Network?
The Incredible Crew, yeah.
Cartoon Network, the Nick Cannon shit.
Nick Cannon.
Oh, bro, I swear to God, I was just sitting just quiet by myself, wasn't nobody in there. And I was just like, oh shit. This nigga was on The Incredibles.
Oh my god.
Surprise.
Now everybody gonna go look at the crazy skits.
Yeah. I'm definitely
Yo,
gonna
the fucking sketch show, the goddamn kids sketch show. That was a kids in living color. And
oh,
fucking
nice.
Great.
Yeah, I wouldn't look at that.
That shit was hilarious. But nah, I've been fucking with you for a long time, dude, and I didn't even realize it. I was trying to figure out where the hell I fucking knew you from. And I'm blessed, man. I'm blessed to be I'm blessed to be here with you, brother. You know. Man.
Here I am, knowing him from Dope, and you know what I'm talking about.
No, it sounded like he knew me from the jump.
Oh, I've been here for a minute.
History.
I've been here for a minute, nigga. It's The Incredible. I've been here for a minute. I know what's going on.
For sure.
Yeah, man. So, you know, just being able to see you grow and see you do different things has been fucking incredible. I mean, no pun intended. That's actually one of my favorite fucking words, and it's weird that I gotta try to not say it now. But no, it's been great just seeing you come up, man. How's your journey been? You've been okay through it mostly. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Growing up on fucking TV. Yeah.
How old were you when you got that?
I might have been like 16 or 17.
That's crazy.
Yeah, yeah.
That's dope.
I'm 26 now, so.
Okay.
Yeah. 10 years.
That helps.
Yeah, right.
That helps. Yeah. So how was that growing up like that, man? Like, was it, did you get accustomed to that life like super early, or were you like already tired of it by the time you got 20?
Nah, yeah. I have big dreams. I have big goals. So for me, you know what I'm saying? Time is a funny thing. I don't want to say it, and then, like, you know, I'm projecting it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But I definitely believe in myself. I have my vision for myself, my vision that I was given, you
Perfect.
Know what I'm saying,
Hell
is,
yeah.
is is saying that there's a lot more to come.
That's fire. Mm-hmm. So, God damn, that's so fire.
I mean, you only 26, bro.
I was about to say,
you got a lot of fucking time.
Legit niggas. And killing it, though.
It's niggas that got started at 46 and was like,
come on
now.
This is good.
Nah, you started so early, man, and you still doing good. He's still doing big shit. It's not like, you know what I'm saying, he's not a kid anymore. We can't use him anymore. Because usually, this motherfucking industry will just spit you out when they're done with your kid.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So just seeing that you went above that shit, done some of the biggest fucking opportunities, man. I mean, it don't get no bigger than the shit you done did, man. Yeah. So I'm very proud of you, bro. I'm glad to see you here.
Yeah!
Let's hope it gets a little bigger.
Isn't it crazy, like, your perspective versus everybody else's? Because you're so humble and wonderful, and I love your spirit. And you're like, I see myself with so much more. And it was like, and you should.
As you should.
The things you have done, though, from 16 to 26.
Name some of them. Let the people know what stuff they know you
It's
from.
Funny. You brought your boy here. That was my first. He put me in my first music video.
Shouts out to Playboy.
Really?
And from that music video, it led to another music video for Soulja Boy. That led to a music video with Kerry Hilson and Lil Wayne. That led to another Soulja Boy music video.
Nice.
That led to a Cartoon Network commercial. That led to Tyler Perry House of Pain audition. It was my first acting audition. I booked that. That led to
House of Pain.
Yeah. That was my first, you know, acting thing. I was like, oh shoot, I'm about to be an actor, you know?
Yeah.
And then Read Between the Lines, and then a couple years later, Incredible Crew came along.
I didn't know you was in Read Between the Lines on BET.
Real quick appearances, you know, just in Atlanta, you know, they looking for local hires for, you know, and I just happened to, at that time, Atlanta is like, you know, you got Marvel movies
for
and everything
sure,
now.
Yeah.
At that time, I mean,
it was rare to get a.
You talking about Tyler Perry House of Pain?
Right.
Or are you talking about BET?
That's who I was working.
You know what I'm saying?
I was working for BET.
Right there on, what is that, 11th Street or whatever, you know what I'm saying?
Turner Studios.
Yeah, that's, you know.
That's where I was at.
Damn.
So I just happened to get Incredible Crew. That took place in L.A., though. So, you know, I was able to drive past a billboard, you know, at like 16 or whatever. And that was like I drove on that street almost every day to get to We Entertain, which is like my, because I'm a dancer. That's how I got in these music videos.
Oh, because I was just about to ask you.
I was about to say, he is a dancing ass nigga.
Are you?
That nigga can dance, bro. God damn.
So you was in the Kerry Hilson with all the dudes. What video was that you was in with Kerry Hilson?
Turning Me On.
It was but had all the set Turning Me On. Okay.
Oh no, I wasn't turning one of them.
You weren't one of them?
I was probably Payne.
Wait a minute, little buster.
You knew that part of the video, didn't you?
That's
the only thing you remember.
The wet dude.
That's why we can't take you nowhere.
Remember that?
Exactly.
That wasn't you.
We can't have
that wasn't me.
Get it. Y'all don't want
I was one of those little kids over there dancing in the
killing
in the,
that
you
shit.
Know I don't remember that part.
You know what I mean?
That's the best part of the video. What are you talking about?
You should not be fantasizing about little kids.
But y'all should look at Crank That Batman. I was that little kid crumping with the red sleeves. I was like,
killing it up. Eating. Getting off. Getting off. That's fucking dope as shit, man. Do you still love it?
I love it. It's a different feeling now. That's a funny question because I want to answer it differently with you because you're like, you know what I'm saying?
Don't do it.
I'm just a nigga with a microphone.
Act like he's not here.
I'm a nigga with a microphone. Come on.
Oh yeah. But I got respect for you. You know what I'm saying?
I appreciate it, man.
No, yeah. So for me, it's like it's a deeper question. I love it. I definitely love it. Mm-hmm. But I desire so much that. It's a task to appreciate the moment.
Oh my
you know
God!
What I'm saying?
Yeah, that was
that's a word right
that was
there.
Deep.
Yeah, that was for me.
That was a word. Listen,
you struck a tone.
My sister used to tell me, learn how to smell your own roses. You know, you stop and smell the roses. She's like, stop and smell your own roses sometimes. Facts.
You know what makes it easier? Just stop and smell your roses. A couple drinks, ladies and gentlemen. Goddamn, Amber coming in this mother. Pan coming with the drinks. Okay. So my wife is a certified mixologist.
Yes,
she got a bartender's license. She
Yay.
Makes every guest their personal own drink. This is a one of one ingredients. All the ingredients are yours.
One
Everything.
Of one.
This recipe is one of one.
I love one.
This,
of one.
This I came up with the name. I wanna take credit with this.
Who came up with the colors?
This is you about to see why it's the colors.
Okay,
this is the mild paralysis. Fucking bars.
That was good.
The paralysis.
Fucking bars, bro. Thank you, everybody.
It's got numb and stuff in it because it just seems like.
Yeah, what's in it? I'm drinking tequila right now.
The mild paralysis. 2 ounces of Cinchoro tequila, 2 ounces of berry punch, and add strawberry soda. Place strawberries into a shaker and muddle. Pour in tequila, berry punch, and ice into shaker with strawberries and shake. Pour over ice into a cup and top with strawberry soda. Garnish with strawberries, and there you have the mild paralysis.
We took into account everything. That's why we called you, brother. Okay. Yeah, we make sure we call ahead, make sure we actually get something you want.
Cranberry.
As red sugar, you know what I'm saying? Got some strawberry in that thing. The mild paralysis.
The mild paralysis.
Mm-hmm. I'm taking this cup.
This one's kind of strong.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, I'm going to have to get one of these straws.
Damn. I think we got more straws.
We got more of these straws.
Yeah, I got to get one of these
straws. I like this straw. Okay. Everything.
You can take these cups, too. We ain't got nowhere to put them.
Seriously. Look at me. Seriously.
So, you know, we had the
it got colder when it
it's supposed to. It's going to hit you. It's going to hit you pretty good. Yeah, that is.
T-Pain always got some expensive shit here.
Donnie.
It's Amazon.
Always got some
he just put
shit.
Me on a new tequila out there. I'm like,
oh, the cilantro.
Michael Jordan?
Oh, the
cilantro.
Cilantro. How I get my own tequila? I need that shit.
That's fucking perfect.
No, I need that shit.
What would you name it?
I'm going to get you on it.
Mr. Moore.
Yeah,
Mr. Moore.
That's right.
That's what you would name it?
That's right.
You said that shit's sexy as shit. I ain't going to lie to you, 26.
No,
you
said that. 26.
You said that, 26.
Yeah.
You hear me?
We love that.
You said we call that the Mr. Moore.
Yeah.
I said, okay, 26.
You never told me why this was red and black.
Because he...
So
I don't want to have to.
Spider-Man, I thought you were going to the Spider-Man thing.
No,
did you not see the spider on the
Spider-Man?
Okay, all right.
Spider-Man. Did you not see the because it's black? Here's a black.
He was into the Spider-Verse.
Yeah.
Into the Spider-Verse. Yeah. Miles Morales.
Miles, you remember?
You ain't on this too? No.
Miles Morales.
I know.
Mike Moranis.
Rick Moranis.
What'd you call the drink again? Something Mr. paralysis?
Mild paralysis.
I was like, okay.
So we went with the black and red, and it was like, I'm gonna do the Spider-Verse shit. Boom. And then we went. He was the voice of Miles Morales.
I got him.
Okay, I'll just. Did you? He didn't get to go to the. Because he was going to the timeline, and then you stopped it, and then trying to figure out why you missed part of the timeline.
But that was really good.
Yeah, thank it's you. Good, thank though, you. Right? Thank yeah, you. You'll figure it out. you know what? We'll be right back.
Shut it down! Jesus Christ! Come on, Pip, get with it.
That's so fat, I can't even stay mad at that. Yeah, you're way too fine. I'd be out of my mind. Relax. I got enough good reasons. It's cuffing season. That's facts. You keep doing me wrong, I'm still rooting you on. Like go, babe, go, go.
Seven ain't easy.
Like go, babe, go, go. You know I'ma be rooting you on. Like go, babe, go.
Seven ain't easy.
Cause I'm cool with that.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. Got Meek Moore and it's Mr. Moore.
Yeah.
Or is that for the ladies?
You know, at some point
sounds like it's for the ladies.
Oh yeah, it's the ladies. I like when the ladies call me Mr.
Okay,
Moore.
Okay, I'm probably not gonna do that anymore then. All right.
So Mr. Moore.
Continue.
You got some shit.
You have my attention.
Continue.
Yes. I'm listening.
You got some Give me the questions, Payne.
You got some, I can't do it. I'm not looking either one of y'all in their eyes.
Now I'm about to be looking over there.
You have to. Go ahead. You have some shit. Go ahead.
I mean, dancer, musician, actor. I want to know about your music. Can we talk? Can we get to that, or you want to stick with the acting?
Don't.
Oh yeah. Don't get in the middle of me and Mr. Moore. Mr. Moore.
Yes, ma'am.
I would really like to know about your music.
Well, you know, we got something on the way for you.
That's okay.
I mean,
you know what? It tingled. I started tingling. No, I ain't gonna lie.
Okay.
You're gonna
have to talk to him regular because this ain't gonna work.
Yeah, it's not gonna track well on the podcast. But you do got shit coming.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because
absolutely.
Did you start as a dancer first, or did you did? Okay, so I thought it was music first, and then dancing, and then you flipped it.
When I danced, it was because of you. The movie You Got Served. I got accepted into this, changed my life. I was in like an all boys military school, Christian school.
Damn.
So yeah, by the time I got to, my dad's a reggae musician, so he came home.
Whoa, you just dropping bombs and shit.
Wait a minute. You're coming out this business rising from the fire like a phoenix. I was buried alive when I was 2 years old. Had to get out of there myself. Zoom.
Damn. What else?
Go ahead. Finish, my brother. I'm sorry. That was
military school. Pops, reggae music.
It was just like, but my parents were never super strict. It was like the school setting that was super strict, though.
Yeah.
So my dad came home. One day I was just, I think I was just like, you know, I was calling his music devil music because it wasn't Christian wow. music, and he did not like that.
You really were pissing him off.
No, yeah, he ain't like that at all. He ain't like that at all.
One love,
like
one all. Heart? Good heart.
He ain't like that at all. So
that was not good.
So I just definitely, you know, I would hear reggae music. I noticed that my older cousin used to play Project Pat. Mm. But my older cousin, he was like, you know, that's like, he's, you know, the men in my family are more... outwardly, you know, masculine with this
okay,
shit.
That's what I thought you were
You know what I'm saying? And so my mom made it a mission to make sure I was a little more like trained, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So that's really the decision there, and I hated it. But by the time I saw you got served, like, I literally left. I went in there with my pants on my belly button, like, you know, and I came out sagging.
Okay.
Like
oh,
I was,
wow.
I was, you know, it. I felt like I touched, you know, this is my first time really getting a dose of culture,
to be honest.
So it had a big effect on me. Next thing I know, I was like dancing in the last school play in the Christian school. Mm. And I got accepted in the DESA, DeKalb Elementary School in the Arts in Atlanta. And there, I got kicked out of my acting class. The lady told me I'd never be an actor.
Ain't that a...
Isn't that hilarious?
Where is she at
because
right
I
now?
Because I had a lot of personality. And it's hard to... You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I speak my mind. I'm a confident young man. You know, and a lot of times people are like, you know, why so confident? I don't think you deserve to be that confident.
Right.
You
right.
know what I'm saying?
People are never this confident. What the fuck you know? What the fuck you got going on?
You know what I'm saying?
You gonna hear me.
Right. Exactly. That's dope, man.
And I never took, you know, I didn't, I think the military school made the idea of someone telling me I can't do something or I gotta do something, like, innately, I'm just like,
mm-hmm. That's fire.
I'm literally rebellious in those ways, but I still know right from wrong.
Right,
it's
right.
Like, you'll never tell me what I can and can't do. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So that's kind of the projection of on the acting side. But dancing, right. You know, how it got to the music, how to bring it all back mm-hmm. around. One of my, you know, friends, her name is Tamara. We were in a ballet class. I was so hot. She put me in a ballet class because they knew I was on the hip hop shit. I was hot. I was like, I'm not wearing no leotards.
All
like
right,
that.
Right.
That's and when I was at that age, that's where my mind was. I was
right.
just like, you
yeah,
know.
For real.
And
I'm not putting that on.
Yeah, yeah. But they let me wear shorts and stuff because I caused a little ruckus or whatever. But out of that, I actually learned a lot, and I noticed that I learned a lot.
Yeah.
I also found that I didn't want to be in any plays, even though,
damn.
Like, you know, plays are like the, you know, you're an actor, you gotta
do
plays.
Yeah, you gotta do plays, yeah.
But I knew I didn't want to do that, you know what I'm saying? And by the time I started working on music videos and stuff, it was like, nah, this is where I felt a little more comfortable.
Okay,
give me a couple takes, let me,
right,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Cause a little ruckus.
You know what I'm saying? Exactly. I went to this dance battle at the Atrium. It used to be like this club that...
Oh, I remember the Atrium.
Oh, we know the Atrium.
Before.
Every last Friday of the month, there was like an event. You know, it's the Atrium,
so my
mom and dad had to take me.
Right.
And they took me, you know, and there, like, I was battling maybe like 10 little dudes. I lost to the last dude, but I beat every dude in between. And when I lost, it was like so many people around. It's my first time really feeling comfortable. I felt free. No one knew me. Mm-hmm. And this is the first time I was dancing. Like, my dad would always tell the story, like, I didn't even recognize that kid. That's what he would say.
Oh,
he was like, I didn't even know he was like,
so cool.
He was that person. So.
Damn, that's fucking
that's
crazy,
cool.
man.
That's when I met the casting directors for his music video and then Soulja Boy's music video. They was inviting me from me because, like, the choreographers for, like, you know, Chris and Usher and Ciara and Justin Bieber, Jason Derulo, Justin Timberlake. And when they dancing, you know what I'm saying? The people that, you know, the stars are hiring are the people I was battling when I was 12. You know what I'm saying?
So y'all cooking. Just met up again.
Cooking. I cooked the best meal of your life. You understand? Like, I mean, you know what I'm saying? So... you know the that's how it happened. When it comes to dancing, only when it comes to dancing.
What's his name? We keep pointing to him. Who is this? I don't know him. Who is it? Come here, baby. Because we done pointed to him several times. So he the reason. And I don't. Come on, get on here, shit.
My name Playboy.
Hey, Playboy.
I was big in the dance era too. I created the Crank That Soldier Boy dance.
Oh shit.
Running Man dance.
Oh shit.
I did a lot of dancing with kids. So when I first seen Meek, he was like crazy. So I was like, man, and he was so young too. And he always been like a little brother with us when we was like doing everything we was doing back then.
Perfect.
But one of my biggest records I had was called Crank That Gang. That's the video we put him in. Then we did the Soldier Boy video.
Yeah.
We did a lot of. He is a fucking star. He's been a star since he been a kid.
That's crazy.
So I always give my man his flowers every time.
That's fire.
Yeah, appreciate that.
So I'm literally watching grow up.
Yeah, Playboy.
Not for real. For real.
That boy actor.
No, yeah, that was my first music video, Crank That Yank. That's my first time I Damn. Introduced myself. The person casting his music video literally helped me get to the place where I am today.
Nice. You know, fire.
Each person like kind of it's like I had to introduce myself as if my parents weren't out there like hustling. I didn't have a team like that knew what they were doing. You know what I'm saying? Like I didn't have none of that. I was just a young dude that was in the military school that was like, oh, I can be on TV now? I'm in a music video? Like, oh shoot, like, you know.
Yeah. No, that's crazy.
So you kind of taking that Don Cheadle path.
What? Talk to me about Don Cheadle.
You ain't seen him in the Angela Winbush video? You ain't seen him in the Angela Winbush video. I'm the only one know about it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. I think so right now.
I'm showing my age. It's cool.
Yeah.
But it's all love, now. Man. I love the comparison. Don Cheadle got some movies out there.
He was a background dancer. He was in the
Really?
What?
I promise he in the Angela Winbush video.
I had no idea.
So man, what's the goals today? What's the goals in this era of your life?
Long story short, I just want to be the best version of myself, and I really believe in myself. So that means musically, I want to make the kind of presence T-Pain made when he first came out.
Oh Jesus,
you feel me? Coming through with that, with them hits, like who is this playing everywhere in the clubs, on the radio? Everybody got to pick up what he was using. Pick it up.
I'm so very glad people already know who you are.
You know what I'm saying?
If I did all that shit and then niggas saw a picture of me, it was like this the nigga. This the nigga. This nigga ain't light skinned.
No, he ain't light skinned. This is a black brother,
the
right here.
Darkest version of himself.
Everybody I came across was like, "Oh, I thought you'd be Puerto Rican."
Why would you think that?
Why would I think that?
Because the talent was transcending your race, your upbringing. The talent transcends that. That's why they thought you was Puerto Rican.
Or all my senior sounded real simpy. I was simping out crazy. They thought I was Drake. They thought I was Drake, crying over bitches. I really appreciate that, man. I appreciate, you know, the kind words, and I appreciate where your head is at this point, and you're not a complete disaster. Because most niggas I know that started at 16 was not doing well.
They're not doing
well. They're not doing great right now.
You see them after pictures, like.
That's a good parenting, to be honest with you. That's the village. Discernment. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, I was raised in a Christian school, all boys military school.
Yeah.
Discernment is important.
I mean, once somebody get buried alive at 2 years old, I mean, that's just crazy. I don't know how you dealt with that. It's a big part of your story, man. Oh, you know,
huge part.
That'll put some discipline in you. Knock some sense into you, if it will. You know, if you will. I can see that, man. I can see how that works. You know what I'm saying? And just keeping your wits about you, keeping your bearings straight, you know what I'm saying? And really traversing this damn industry like you got all conditions gear on. So, you know what I'm saying? I fuck with that, bro. Like, you really held this shit together.
When you were dancing, how did you
how were you able to get up front to the acting part? Because you started with the, was it Tyler Perry, right?
Mm-hmm. No, I started with the Pop It Off Boys, yeah.
Ah, but how, so when you got to the front, how did you project yourself out there to let them know, I need to be
yeah, I'm not here. Just a dancer.
To, to the front of the music video?
Yeah.
You know, I walk up, honestly, because at the time, maybe it was just my perception or maybe it was my hunger. I don't know, but I never looked at another human being and like, no, I'm lying. Chris Brown and Rocky, you know, really like, I then knew like, okay, there's a such thing as like starstruck, you know what I'm saying? No, not for real. There's a such, but before then, you know what I'm saying? Like casting directors or the people, you know, in between the in-betweens, mm-hmm. like, you know what I'm saying? I grew to appreciate the importance that they play, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? But while I was coming up, none of that mattered. It was just like, yo, I know that I'm like, I know what I know. And like, you're able to help me accomplish that. Right. You know what I'm saying? So I'm going to walk up to you. I'm in absolutely. Your vicinity.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't care who's in between boom. Me and you. You know what I'm saying? Yo, y'all are done. Before y'all, let me get one
let
take.
Me get it off.
What? What you talking? You know
what
I'm saying?
Get off
like,
real quick.
Question, like, but I'm the type of dude to be like, nah, like, you give me one take. I only need one.
You're right.
You know what I'm saying? You're going to be happy when you're done. But I'm 12 talking like this. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, at that time, it's just like,
they probably felt that shit. Like, let this
yeah,
live.
Yeah, yeah. I'm curious what he's talking about.
Yeah,
let me,
I want to see.
Don't hurt.
I've never had nobody do this before.
We got a lot of film. Just go ahead and just go.
And so from there, like, it wasn't even like, you know, because from there, it was just the casting directors and the people kind of, because they have a job too. And I learned that much later.
Mm-hmm.
Like, when you're at that stage and you need people, it's like, you guys are like, and they love that. You know what I'm saying? That power. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I had the opportunity to meet Kay Clark, who was operating so many music videos in Atlanta. And I'm mm-hmm. shouting you out because you really did affect my career at the beginning. And, you know, from there, it's just kind of like you learn that people are people, like, you know, and mm-hmm. they, you know, it's more about talking to people. And when people get a feeling of who you are, you know, they deal with you the way that you present yourself.
For sure. Mm-hmm.
You know what
God.
I'm saying?
I tell women that all the time.
That's so important. Yeah. It really is.
The way that you present yourself.
It's okay, though, because it's okay.
Right. It's okay.
It's okay because
it's going to be okay.
Okay.
We're still
okay.
who we are.
Yeah.
All right. I need another drink. We'll be right back.
Shut it down. Down, down, down.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. Meek is fucking killing it.
Yes,
he took us deep. I think he did mushrooms before he got here. if not, I got something back there. It's fine. Right.
That's so, like he's stingy.
Oh, my God.
Super.
Meek, it is time for your top five.
Top five!
Top five. I hope I don't embarrass myself right now.
Nah, this is going to be great. You know, we try to give everybody their own top five. So it's not like a, you know, a set thing to where you can get prepared for it and shit. We try to switch it up every now and then. Uh-huh. So you won't be fucking watching the show before you get here and be like, all right, that's what I'm going to say. Who are your top five favorite actors and actresses? Mm. Boom! No specific order. Please do not order this shit.
Tom Hardy is an animal.
I love Tom Hardy.
Tom Hardy is an animal.
He is an animal.
You didn't need time for that at all.
No, no. Tom Hardy is an animal.
He came off killing it. He is an animal.
Mm-hmm. You know, I don't know why I love Halle Berry, but I do.
It's okay.
It's like,
you don't need an explanation.
But I look. No, but like for me personally, like there are a lot of beautiful women in Hollywood.
For sure.
You know what I'm saying? So Halle Berry is gorgeous, like, you know, but
yeah, it's over the top.
But like, what is but what is it that, like, it's that those, I don't even, I've seen like maybe like 6, 7, 8 of her movies.
Yeah.
And it's like, it's a thing, like, I don't even know what it is, that it's past the beauty. It's like something else that she got going on that I can appreciate. So I gotta mention Halle Berry.
You just got so much ass off this right here.
Yeah, I like it.
I'm hanging out with you.
What we doing this weekend? Nigga, we going to the club tonight.
We is friends
with Mr. Moore.
What is going on in here?
I have some fun.
Yes.
All right, so that's two. That's two.
You know, I just watched this movie called The Game that fucking blew my mind.
The Game?
The Game. I don't even expect nobody. Have you seen that? Nobody's seen
the
it.
Game?
I don't expect anybody to watch. I like movies that really, I can guess how movies go today.
You know, like captivating shit. You like shit that, you know, you want something
on your
different.
Toes. You I'm have like, no idea. Like, literally, no matter what you think, that's not what's going to happen.
I'm watching Squid Game.
That's
not
the
Squid
one
Game.
I want to see.
Not Squid
Game. The Game. Yeah. You know what I'm talking about? Squid Game.
Okay. I don't know Squid Game.
Oh, okay. I do like movies that take shit, that take what you think, what they already know what you think is going to happen, and they just flip the
like completely. Yeah. And they're older movies. I noticed that, like, they're in on Netflix, they got so many OG movies, but you got to, like, the algorithm real specific. I don't like nobody on my Netflix.
It's
like, I got four other accounts. Like, y'all using the Netflix account? Okay, use my mom's account. Use my dad, my grandma.
Don't,
you know what I'm saying?
Don't
use Shameik, because this algorithm got to be hidden when it's time. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Come.
For real.
When the times come, you like.
No, you got to be looking. And I add them to my list, because sometimes it's hit or miss. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? But thank you so much.
So is The Game an older movie?
Yeah, it's older. It's in the 80s and whatnot, I believe.
Who's in The Game?
His name, I know Sean Penn is in it, but
yeah, I'm familiar, but I don't think I watched
Sean
it.
Sean Penn is in it, but the dude I'm talking about, the lead guy, his, like, if you said his name, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, brother, because you know what I'm saying, I just, your work hit me, but that's how it is with me too. Niggas don't know my name. Niggas, you know what I'm saying? They're like, Shaolin Fantastic, Raekwon, you know what I'm saying? Miles Morales, it's all good. We on the same page.
They don't know,
you know what I'm saying? Like,
that's what I'm saying.
They know my face way before they know my name right now.
I got you now.
Not the one with Michael Douglas and
Michael Douglas,
Sean Penn. Here are the people.
Oh yeah, okay.
The people.
This is the one right here.
This is our research team. It's just her and her phone.
Oh no, I was talking about Sean Penn.
You was talking about Sean Penn.
Sean Penn is the dude I was referring to.
Oh, fucking Sean Penn.
So that's good. But the dude playing his brother also is a fucking amazing actor. Thank you.
You're welcome.
But okay, so that would be my three.
Sean Penn is three.
So we got Sean Penn.
Sean Penn is three.
That worked.
Number four is, you know, from Euphoria.
Okay.
Zendaya really, like, I knew of Zendaya because I was testing when I got Incredible Crew, which you brought up.
Yeah.
I was also testing for Shake It Up on Disney Channel.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
They changed the name to Ty Blue because of my audition. Like, they were going to, like, I was in there signing contracts and shit. Anyway,
what?
It was a very sad moment for me at the time, but you know, there's always a bigger plan. I was in the audition phase. They was like, oh, we think we're going to call him Ty Blue now. Okay, cool. And next thing I know, well, we found somebody that looks more like her brother. And I was like, damn.
Oh. Colorism.
That's racist.
But it was all good. I was literally, my mom was there. We had contracts in front of us. But anyway, the point of, of what was the point?
Sister Zendaya.
You were saying Zendaya?
Oh, yeah. I've been following her from the jump, so I've seen her work. I'm telling, like, in Euphoria, she tapped into something. Malcolm and Marie, you know, while I have so much respect for David Washington, I mean, when I met him, it was like he was super. People be like, you know what I'm saying? You know how it go. Like, you know, who got the biggest? You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
So, I, you know, of course I walk in, like, you know, relaxing with my energy. But then I'm like, you know, What you mean? Who got the biggest? You know, you want to see me on screen? It's good. Like, you know what I'm saying? But it's all in the eyes. I never say that to nobody. Right. It's just, I leave it in the energy, you know? So.
I'm going to have to start doing that.
Making me feel uncomfortable from over there. This is. But no, I get you. So,
I said all that to get back to Zendaya. I follow her career. I think she tapped into something new when she hit Euphoria. I can give her some credit as one of my favorite actors right now.
That's dope.
You know what I'm saying? She has Spider-Man, this movie Dune, and Euphoria. Yep. Mm-hmm. She's shitting on me right now. And I gotta get back to.
She's major though.
You know what I'm saying?
She really is in a lot of ways.
Yeah, well, she's dope.
You know, much,
shout out to that Dune. I'm not gonna ask you if you saw the original, but anyway.
Mm-hmm. When was the original?
In the 80s, man.
What time is it? All right, number five. This
oh
is
shit!
It.
I'm sorry, it takes so long to get to five. My bad.
No, it always does. We usually take about five, six minutes to get to each one.
Number five. You know, I'm just gonna put myself in that list.
Go ahead, Mr. Confident, Mr. Moore.
Yeah, if you don't do that,
that was crazy.
Come on now.
Very nice. Very nice. Well, that's a good top five. Goddamn.
Yeah, I like your top five.
Yeah, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, we will be right back.
Shut it down.
Confession, I never been high like this. Yeah. How do you expect niggas to drive like this? I got feathers on my dresser, I get fly like this. Yeah. 150 on the dash. Ooh. Sitting still on an ass. Ooh. I need to remedy. This shit is sending me times infinity. Shit. Goddamn. Don't need that minute, so y'all mind the energy. This shit is hitting me. Shit. Oh, man. Y'all ain't feeling it. Y'all intensity. Keep it 250 feet. Y'all been pissing me.
On today's episode of How Fucked Up Is Fucked Up. That's fucked up.
Shameik!
Mm-hmm.
What's fucked up?
A lot's fucked up, but a lot is great too. You know what I'm saying?
We're just looking for the fucked up. I don't
think about the extra.
A lot is great too.
What's fucked up? We just want something that you think is real fucked up.
What's fucked up?
And it can be the most stupid thing. You can say people that put the drink in a cup before they put the ice in. Because that's weird.
Oh, I don't like that because then it's flicker back at you.
I think that misinformation is fucked up.
Misinformation. Yeah. That is really fucking good. Please elaborate, my brother. I would love to.
I mean, misinformation in general, like being told something that, you know, or just being worried about what's real and what's not real. What's you know, what are you supposed, the decisions you got to make with yourself, you
for
know,
sure,
on a day to day, whatever situation, based on what. You know, the right people say is right, and what the misinformation in the public says is right. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Because we're artists, so when you're exposed to, like, you know, we're all artists. You know what I'm saying? So when you're exposed to, like, the media, you understand, like, some, you could say some shit, or some shit could go down, and there's like. The main, like, the headline of it, which does play an effect on people, because that's
sure.
what people
Absolutely.
Read. And
that's
understand.
All they read. It's the only fucking thing they read.
If they go any deeper, it's still like you could go deeper, but the headline is still like
you already
still
had
the bad guy.
You already had that preconceived notion of where it was gonna go.
So it's so powerful, because, like, you can meet somebody in person and be like, damn, that's nothing like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But, like, the media, you know, in general, so with that, I mean, and you could go back to as far as, like, you know, the skin tone of Christ. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, what? No, but
that
for real.
That's real shit.
All I'm saying is misinformation has been going on since 10 generations before us right
for
now.
Sure. Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? So what to believe? I think that by itself, we're fed information. We're born into a society that already existed. Like, with its fuck ups and with its, like, you know, pluses from literally generations before us.
Big backs.
You know what I'm saying?
Wait.
I'm not thinking about my great, 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 great grandchild right now. But my decisions right now are affecting them.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? So it's, I mean, that by itself, misinformation, you know, that has a lot to do with my story in total.
Yeah.
You know, I desire to inspire people in order to do something with the effect I have on people that really will change. If it doesn't completely change, it has a major effect on, because, you know, it's one lifetime that Shameik right. Moore will be seen in this
remember.
Form.
Mm-hmm. That you remember.
You know what I'm
yes,
saying?
Sir.
In this form, you know what I'm saying, is I give you 100 years. And so 100 years in God, you know what I'm mm-hmm. saying?
Yeah.
Is like, what am I doing with that? That's how I think, mm-hmm. you know?
That's dope.
And I think about everybody's years across time in general
mm-hmm.
the same way. You mm-hmm. know what I'm saying? I look at greats and I'm like, they were human.
Yes,
they were born.
For sure. Yeah.
They were born to earth. You know what I'm saying? They mm-hmm. peed. They had to
peed.
Do a number two.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They had to figure out. They had to find confidence. They
yeah.
had to find God. Mm-hmm. They had to. They loved someone.
Mm-hmm.
You know what
Absolutely.
I'm saying? They felt insecure at times. Like all these emotions, these human emotions, we all went through. And then you have people like Jesus that existed. You have people like Buddha and et cetera. Like,
mm-hmm,
you know what I'm
mm-hmm.
saying? These people existed. These are our superheroes, and you are capable of doing those things.
Yeah. Yep.
And from, but they're painted like so that far away.
Unobtainable.
Yeah.
It's unobtainable.
Oh my gosh,
yeah.
we can walk on water? No way.
yeah.
You know?
Like, right. yeah.
No, you know what I'm saying? I've personally never walked on water yet.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But, you know.
Y'all niggas saw somebody do it. I'm about to try it.
You know what I'm saying?
I get that. I get
yeah.
that. That makes sense. Misinformation is fucked up. I appreciate
I
that.
Do.
That's really good. Hell yeah.
We're going through a corrective period. We're going through a corrective period. Even in the educational system, you know, where we
yeah.
all thought that, you know what I mean? We were going along with the whole Thanksgiving moment.
We're trying.
and just all the other things that they said it was. And
right.
now it's like, come on, let's just tell the truth about America.
Yep.
Let's just
mm-hmm.
tell the truth about what happened.
Yep.
Let's
mm-hmm.
stop glorifying bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
Let's
right.
stop.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Let's just tell the truth. It's not gonna hurt. It's not gonna change anything. Because
yeah,
what
yeah,
happened
yeah.
happened.
Absolutely.
But it will right. change the way that people perceive themselves, the way that they
change the way we move forward.
Right.
Come on now.
Yeah, it'll change the way we move forward. That's
right.
it. Instead of just repeating the same bullshit and regurgitating the same misinformation,
that's
it'll
right.
change the way people fucking move forward. And
yep.
that's
but that,
my friends.
That's the
powerful.
That's the true task, like, you know, for everyone. Is you got different misinformations in so many different ways.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know what
yeah.
I'm saying? So
yeah.
going beyond that, like something you've been told, you know, this is blue your whole life. So
mm-hmm.
if I was to tell you that the real name of this color is red,
mm-hmm.
you'd be like,
yeah.
no, the fuck
nah.
it's not.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
red. Like,
yeah.
You know
yeah.
what I'm saying?
Right, yeah.
I'm 62, I'm 82, I'm 100 years old. This is red. No,
yeah.
actually.
Let me take it back for you.
400,000 years ago, they said it was Hukasinga.
Yeah. We just started calling it.
Calling
you know what I'm saying?
Right. We started calling it. Shit called Hukasinka.
I was looking at a lot of stuff, a lot of names.
No. Hukasinka? Yeah. yeah.
The way
that's
we perceive time, like the clock, and so somebody created
right.
that
they
system.
Did.
We
Absolutely.
Were born into this system.
All that shit.
And
man.
We, you know, we live this way. So we, you know.
I get messed up when people remind me that July is from Julius Caesar. You know what I mean?
Oh,
or August is from Augustus.
I didn't know that.
I didn't know that. You just fucking told me something.
Right. Yeah.
Let's Google that.
Let's make sure you're right.
But no,
where's
August is from. No, it's from people though. Like August was from they changed the way that the time that the months and shit
up.
Like that. Mm-hmm. Like that's a real thing. Like it's from Augustus, whoever. That's what August is for. Or whatever. No, it's real.
So what was before that then?
I forgot what it was called because I'm not that smart. But I know that there was a name of it before. Like the name Africa is not the name of Africa. It was called something else. I forgot
mm-hmm.
the name. When I was younger, my dad used to tell me all that stuff.
Egypt was called Kemet.
Thank you. So I'm saying like we changed
yeah.
the names of things.
Mm-hmm. I'm all fucked
y'all
up.
Y'all vibing?
I'm serious. If
I'm
you,
all fucked up.
Because I don't know. What?
I mean, it's right here. I just didn't want to take the time.
So when you take notes, you're right. You get out your sketchbook. You get out your phone.
You
start
that.
Taking notes. I need to know these things.
You got to have that. That's
right.
a real thing.
Africa original name, Alkabulin or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
It's here, though. I'm
it's
not
right there.
It
it's
anything
right there.
That you see on there is what it is.
Yeah. Yeah, you know. Anything this makes it real. This makes it real.
I want to let you know.
Oh,
that's
man.
What it is. Nah,
I don't know.
That.
But I feel you. Misinformation's
and,
a mofo.
And misinformation.
I didn't know who my daddy was for a long time.
That's
I
right.
hate misinformation. Yeah. I'm joking.
Yeah.
I always knew
yeah.
who my dad
is.
Shout
that
out to Reverend
it.
Brian Stephen Fraction.
That
I'm always known.
That was it.
But misinformation.
Misinformation is... fucked up.
Yeah.
Come on.
Nice.
God damn, that was a roller coaster.
Shut it down.
Oh,
oh man.
Guys, go pre-order my new book. Look at this shit. You know what I had to fight for in this fucking book? And I'm so glad that I held my ground on this. Because it was just going to be a normal joint. See how that looks? Now, what you can't tell is that all the pages are black with gold writing. Look at that. I'm so glad I held my foot on this. Look at that. Oh, all the pages are black.
It's gorgeous.
I put my book in dark mode for y'all. See what I did? Now if that don't deserve a pre-order, I put my book in dark mode for everybody. If y'all could just go pre-order this, make this a bestseller, man. I want to have a bestseller. And it's not something that you necessarily have to read. I gave two of these to my kids today, and my daughter was like, I don't drink, but I'll take one. I know you don't drink. What the fuck are you talking about?
Meek, what is the Nappy Boy Radio song of the week?
Ooh. Nappy Boy Radio
song of the week. What is it?
I'm sprung.
Damn.
You mother.
I knew you were gonna put on one of your tracks.
Damn!
Come on, baby.
Fuck, now we got
it. Taking it back to the old school, cause I'm an old fool. Old school.
Yo, Fizzle, it's popping, B.
Hey, kinda Don.
Right now, word is in the hood, man. You up here sprung with this new lady.
I don't know what you're talking about, cuz.
Come on, man. We got the picnic popping, man. We got chicks over here. Man, you gotta come join us, dog.
All right, I'll see y'all in a minute.
Yo, I don't think he's coming through, dog. Probably up there locked up.
I'm sprung, thoughts you got me doing things I'll never do.
The Nappy Boy Radio Song of the Week.
Song of the Week.
You do, you do,
some kisses. I'm cooking for when she gets hungry. All she doing is acting like she want me. She counting off all my homies, even all of my other ronies. She ain't even my main lady. See, I've been thinking about it lately. Man, she really don't deserve me. All she wanna do is hurt me. So I gotta get away from her. But now I'm leaving quickly. Before she come and try to get me. Everything with me.
Well, I'll come down to
my home. No, she got me doing things I'll never do. If you ain't been, I'm telling you. I'll
Pizzle, what's up, man? Come on, get up out of here. We waiting on you. We outside.
Do not leave me.
Yo, Payne, seriously, man. We outside. We trying to get to the next spot. Can you get out of here now?
I'm coming out there in 1 second.
Yo, boo. He say he coming, but I don't believe him. Let's be out.
Well, let's be out, man. Let's get it.
That was three different tones.
The phones as thick as a motherfucker.
God. Aww. Damn.
That's fire right
there.
Yeah,
so, God damn, that was
terrible. That was fun.
That was very terrible.
That wasn't terrible at all. Them videos right there.
That was not a walk down memory lane.
100,000.
You know what I'm saying?
Nightmare on Elm Street.
Damn, I would love to meet T-Pain. He got a concert. Where's that at? No. Oh, man, can I get in? Does anybody got a ticket?
No. Hell no.
How do we get to meet T-Pain?
Nobody. Get the fuck out of here. It's during these trying times, keep your bitch ass in the crowd. We'll be right back.
Shut it down.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. I am your homeboy T-Pain, a.k.a. your girlfriend's boyfriend.
I am Vanessa Fraction, a.k.a. Action Fraction, the main attraction, your partner's distraction.
And I am Pip, a.k.a. Mr. God damn!
You got any of those? You got
shit, I'm Shameik Moore. They call me Shaolin Fantastic, the lady killing romantic.
Shit!
Yeah, we going out tonight. Take this, nigga.
Oh, Mr. God. Moore, I really like that.
Keep like talking that, to me Mr. like that.
Okay. Well, I'm married. I got to shut the fuck up.
There we go.
I got to shut the fuck up.
Please.
I like a challenge.
This would be the one podcast my husband listened to.
This is the one.
What you be over there doing? Oh,
now I know.
Now I'm coming with you.
Now I'm coming with you.
Oh, man. I just been living life, minding my business, fellas.
All right. Shameik Moore!
What's the word? What's the word? What's the word? Let's get to the good stuff.
It is time for the button question.
Okay, cool.
Boo, 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 boo.
Here we go. Who's going to ask it?
It's me. Okay. Meek.
Mm-hmm.
A man is invited into your home.
That's right.
Do-do-do. He sits down at your table.
Uh-huh.
He produces a button.
That's right.
Boom. Button right there.
Mm-hmm.
He says, Mr. Moore, if you hit this button, you can have anything your mind can think of.
You hear what I said?
Oh, damn it.
Okay. Hold on. So,
Let him finish.
He says, you can have any tangible item. Any tangible thing. It's not a magic button.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a magic button. You can have any tangible thing your mind can think of.
Mm-hmm.
All you have to do to get it is hit the button. But when you hit the button, someone in the world dies.
Boom.
Kaboom. And also, if you don't hit the button,
you die.
Boom. Extra kaboom. Mr. Moore, what is that one thing you would like to acquire?
God damn it.
I told you.
What?
The one thing I would like to acquire is...
How are you this fast?
The funding I need to do what I need to do to become what I'm trying to become. And at the same time, while I'm getting that that funding is coming from, it must come from someone that is about to pass already peacefully, that understands that they'll be affecting the universe in a way that
okay, we're gonna back up.
They can't even comprehend.
We're gonna back up some.
I like the thoughtfulness.
Who is this?
Yeah, this thing happens one time.
One time.
This thing happens one time.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously, you can't stop anybody from dying.
That's so right.
It's gonna happen.
We're all gonna die.
So things happens one time, right when you hit the button, and nobody gets to pick who dies.
Uh-huh.
It's just gonna happen.
Who all could die, Payne?
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, you come into my favorite part. All the possibilities of people that die. When you hit that button, a 25-year-old with phenomenal health, boom, middle of the street, heart attack.
Gone.
She dead.
Could be second Hitler. You never know. You know what I'm saying? Could be killing off something that actually needed to be killed
Gone.
Off. Could be a baby. This thing happens one time, right away, not a magical button, and it has to be a tangible thing.
Do you happen to know when I'm going to die?
That's crazy.
I can pull up an app that claims it's a timer. I was like, yeah. I know that when you hit that button, somebody that wasn't supposed to die at that time.
No.
Somebody that was
and
destined.
If I don't hit it, I die.
Yeah. Correct.
Don't do it.
Immediately.
You better
immediately.
Not do it.
Not immediately. The dude has to leave. I mean, you know. You don't have the keys to your house. You might have to lock it from the inside or something. All right. Good choice. Go. Boom. Closes the box. Walks out. You die. Man.
Don't.
Somebody or you. And what's that thing?
Don't even act like you're going to do
what's
it.
What's that thing that you'd be like, boom. Fuck them kids.
I mean, people have had answers. There's been answers.
There's been a lot of answers. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. No, take your time. I want you to take your time.
I mean,
this is not something you're supposed to be able to come up with something for. It's a pretty fucked up question. So you got to think. You got to be real fucking shallow about it to really come up with boom. What is
all
it?
Right.
Then we bring that person back.
Can't. It's not a magic bunny.
What you didn't? You coming up with new rules every time I find a way to.
I said it.
Every time I find a way to finesse.
I said this earlier. It's not a magic button. I said a tangible thing. A tangible thing that you can touch, see, smell, acquire.
All right. All right. All right.
It's not a magic button.
He did say that.
I did say that.
Okay. Right.
Mm-hmm. Ain't no wishing for a bigger dick. None of that. None of that.
This girl is funny. You gotta apply them tricks, brother. Brother at home, this is what you gotta do. Okay? You gotta spit. You gotta use your wrists. You gotta use your fingers. You gotta slide in. You gotta goddamn. You gotta talk to her. You gotta give her what she needs. You understand?
Oh,
you
shit.
Use the toys.
And ain't nobody gonna hit the button?
Ain't nobody gonna hit the button? No, we got this. This is a straight segment. Here we go. Mr. Moore, what's that thing now? Come on now. Hit us with it. Hit us with it. What you got? What's that one thing that you would hear?
You know boom, what? If it's my time. If it's my time. If it's my time, I'm going to live another day.
Okay, what do you got?
I'm going to get the funding I need to make what I need to make. In order to get to where I need to go so that the death of whoever God chose to die will not be in vain and it will affect the history.
One is not God.
God is everything.
You chose it.
Which is exactly right. God is within me. That means God decided to.
You better come on.
You know what I'm saying?
You hit the button, though.
God is everything good and evil.
You did hit the button. You hit the button.
I hit the button. Somebody died. That was within God. Just like God is within this hand. And God is within this idea that's going to project and create, just like God does create.
Did you kill a little bit of God? Did you kill a little bit of God?
God is infinite. Death is nothing to God. God is energy.
Shameik.
What is the physical life? Death? Death? There's no such thing. There's no such thing as death. It's just perception. It's that misinformation that we have out here, bro.
It's just the time that we remember.
Take some mushrooms or something.
Can't fear death, bro. You gotta fight it. You know what I'm saying?
I don't fear it. I just don't. I don't want it.
Welcome it.
No one wants to die.
Yeah,
because
some,
of our physical
some,
attachment to this
I'm very
earth,
attached.
You feel me?
I got some other shit I want to do. So your thing would be the funding you need to do whatever you need to.
Mm-hmm.
Whenever you feel like it.
Mm-hmm. To be the person he wants to be.
To be the person you need to be.
What was that? Was that a question?
No, that was. I'm reiterating what you said. That's what you'd hit the button for.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. I would get what I need in order to do what I need to do in order to gain what I need to gain in order to change what I need to change.
To be the
I understood one of those words. Mm-hmm. All right, cool. Good stuff. There it is. Goddamn fastest button question on the man. We gonna figure this out. We will be right back. That was fucking hilarious.
I knew he was going there.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Netboy Radio Podcast. Goddamn, Shameik Moore has been one of the fucking deepest guests we've
very
had.
Very intriguing.
This nigga came in here fucking prepared.
He said it from the beginning how he was going to be.
Damn, ain't nobody talking man. This nigga, nigga reading books on the way here and shit.
Yeah, so yes, is that my notes? Or did he text it to me? I text it to me.
Damn, nigga came here with Marcus Garvey's memoir. Do that shit before you got here. All right, all good. It's all good. We love a fucking enlightened brother. I tell you that shit, man. Oh, man. I appreciate you actually being who you are, man. Traversing this industry like you do, man, and really being the person that you are. You know, I know we make fun of the shit, but it's very refreshing to see. I'm
thank you.
And the audience, if you don't know what I'm saying, I'm very glad he's not dumb.
Because you got to explain shit around this, brother.
Yeah,
right. Hold on, wait a minute.
I got you. I'm so glad you're not stupid. There it is.
Oh, man.
On the back of that, here is Shameik Moore, creative curse word of the week. Now, let me tell you what you're going to do. You're going to take this book. You're going to open this bitch up right here. Here's step one. Here's step two. Random page on this side. Random page on this side. Shameik, what is your creative curse word of the week? Okay, starting off good.
Whore.
What's the other side?
I just need the other one to be.
That's it. Whoo.
Monster.
Whore monster. Damn.
You fucking whore monster. How could you fucking disrespect me like that?
It was that close. It would have been that close, but it's got to be. So, in order to get us out of here, Mr. Moore, we have to have you use that in a sentence, but like not just like saying the word right away or calling
it has
somebody.
To define.
It has to be like a blah, 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 but. Blah 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 blah.
Oh my gosh! I went to DR. Yo, son, that shit right there was crazy. I was like, yo, I'm getting kind of lonely out here. Shorty out there in America. She said she don't want to come to DR. I'm right. Like, yo, I got the nice place set up and all that. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. All right, son. So I, you know what I mean? My homie, my barber out there. He like, okay, cool. So I'm mm-hmm. gonna just go out in the city. I'm like, right. What that mean? I'm in Cabrera. He said I'm going to Punta Cana. I was
right,
like, okay,
right.
Cool. So you gonna drive 4 hours that way? He said, I'm taking a helicopter. I'm like, whoa. Okay, bet. I see right. What's going on. We got money over here.
Okay.
All right, cool. So he land, he get his chicks, he come over there to the Cabrera spot.
Uh-huh,
you heard. And the shorties that was there was, you know, we had the good service and all that.
Gotta have the good service.
We had the good service mm-hmm. and all that. You know what I'm saying? We had the, I don't know if we had the MJ tequila, but we had some good.
Listen,
we had some good tequila.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? They were satisfied. You
right,
know what
right,
I mean?
Right.
The infinity pool was twice the size of your imagination. You heard? Right on the cliff. We got the ocean out there.
Uh-huh.
So it's crazy right now.
Right, know? Right.
All
right,
so listen. Yo, so... So I'm like, yo, I'm just, you know what I'm saying, I'm feeling good, son. Like, you know what I mean?
Right.
I'm trying to get busy, you heard?
Mm-hmm.
So, like, you know what I'm saying? Just go ahead and do, you know, which one you want, shot shit. You know what I'm saying? It don't even matter, you heard? Like,
right.
You know what I'm saying? None of them, you know what I mean? I just want the lights off, you know what I mean? And
boom.
Just send them up, you know what I mean? I'm
right.
Just going to be laying down, just telling what the business is. I'm not doing this. I'm not doing that. I'm not doing this. I'm not doing that. Son, like, yo, I got you. I'm like, don't send no whack. I got you. Okay, word. So I'm getting cozy in my bed, you heard?
Right.
I'm getting, you know what I'm saying? I got the music going, all
mm-hmm.
that. It's all
mm-hmm.
good. It's all love, you heard?
Yeah.
So, you know what I'm saying? They come upstairs. It's more than one. I thought it was one. You know what I'm saying?
Right,
he's
right.
saying more than one up there to take
That's
care
it.
Of the kid. You know what I'm saying? It's feeling good and all
yeah,
that.
Yeah, perfect.
You
perfect.
Heard? You heard? No disrespect to the ladies out there, but
nah,
yo, listen, know. Like, you know what I'm saying? Shorty did her business and all that and was asking for cash. And I was like, yo, I don't do all that.
Okay.
You know, her whole situation changed. I was in the dark and I felt like I was talking to like some crazy yo, it was a horror monster.
Got so scary.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was the goddamn National Radio Podcast. Thank y'all for coming. Thank you for letting us down. Shameik Moore, this motherfucker. Oh my God, you got something to say to the people? Say something to the people, goddamn it.
Hey, yo, man, thank you for having me up here.
Hey, man,
you know what I'm saying? That was a good laugh.
God damn,
thank you, Mr. Moore.
Ooh, oh, she keep talking. Listen,
all right, let's get the fuck out of here. Come on, everybody, peace the fuck out. Hey.
Thank you.
Oh, shit.
That was fucking great, man. I appreciate that shit, man.
She sucked my dick so scary.
That was about 10 minutes, bro.